Right, so we have all the images that we need, and now we need to download the DEMs, the digital elevation models. Okay, so we are going to download it from the net as well, from the website. So we go to our web browser and we are going to type IDE Aragón Descargas, which is the Geographical Information System website for the region of Aragón in the northern Spain. Okay, and here we have the collection and we need to search for the DEMs, which is at the bottom, Modelo Digital del Terreno 2012 and 2015. These are the two that we are going to use. So type on the first one, so click on the first one, choose Municipio, which means municipality, and type Benasque as we did before for the aerial images. And below you will find the ones which are available. We are going to choose the H31_180_1, this one here. Right, this is in the same projection that we have in our project. So, descargar, which means download, you click here and it will start downloading. It is a zip file, so you need to unzip it later, okay, and store it wherever you want it to store in your computer. Once we have it, we choose the 2015 for the same municipality, Benasque, and see here that we have four available. We are going to choose the 180, but see that the projection is going to be different. It's 25, 25, 8, 30, which means the zone 30 and not the zone 31, that is the one that we are using. Okay, again, click ASC and descargar, which means download. And this projection problem, it is not an issue because QGIS will handle it automatically, but we need to do some things in advance, you will see now. Once it is available, it is downloaded, also zipped, you have to unzip it, and we are ready to load them, both of them, into our project. Right? There it is. I have already stored them before, so they are available and we can go back to our project and download and load the DEMs. So we go to raster layer, add raster layer, and this is the 2012 one. Open. And you see that there will be a warning. If you click add, there will be a warning because it doesn't have a projection defined, okay? And it has defined a default projection, which is not the one that we are using. The same will happen with the 2015 image. So we will have to define that ourselves, but we know which one it is. This is 25, 25, 8, 30, and the 2012 is 25, 8, 31, okay? So once we have loaded both of them, right click, for example, I'm going to put 2012 on top. So we have some order here. We need to be a bit tidy, otherwise it becomes a mess. Right click, set CRS, sorry. And here we choose 25, 8, 31. Okay. Similar thing to the other DEM, but remember that this one, the its projection is 25, 8, 30. We need to set the right projection, and then the program will automatically reproject this image to the one that we are using in our project. And you can see that it's slightly tilted, that's because it has been reprojected. But both, they fit perfectly, so there's no problem about that. Let's check that we have all the information that we need. So we have the limit on top that we will need no more later. We have the image for 2012 that is in a WMS layer. So every time that we change anything, it needs to reload from server, but it doesn't use space in our computer. We have the image for 2012 as well, remember, for 2018, sorry, as well, remember, and we have two DEMs for 2012 and 2015. This is all we need to start our project, so we can go to project and save.